Hello, thank you for being here. I'm Kulfi, also known as Daniel Faucon, and I'm presenting CryptoCat. So CryptoCat is a project created by Nadim Kobeisi, also known as Kaepora on Twitter. And CryptoCat is, of course, an open source software, and it does chatroom encryption in the browser, and is focused on usability by non-experienced users, I mean normal people, and it looks like this. So the question you might ask yourself is, why CryptoCat? Why do we need something new? In the security community, we don't like new things very much because we like using proven stuff, stuff that has been proven to work and is known for years. So every time someone comes with a new project, new idea, we always must ask ourselves, do we need something new, or can we do it with the existing stuff? Can we avoid making new things that will have new mistakes and fall into pitfalls and make everything look bad? So why do we need CryptoCat? Because right now we have OTR. OTR is great, it works perfectly. So why do we need something else than OTR? So first, OTR doesn't do chat rooms. So that means that OTR can only do one-on-one conversations. You can only have a secure communication with one other person. And it looks like a very tiny problem, that something unimportant, but in fact, the use cases we are seeing nowadays is that communities need to have secure communications, not only a pair of individuals, but communities. And we cannot ask for everyone to have 15 windows open to talk with 15 other people and try to have a working organization like that. It doesn't work. It's not realistic. So we need something that works in a chat room. We need to bring encryption to communities, not only to individuals, but to communities. And the other big problem there is right now is that we have great tools. We have very good cryptography, but people still use Google Gtalk. People still use Skype. People still use Facebook chat. And people get spied on because of that. They get arrested. Some people get killed because they use those solutions. We have some answers to those problems, but they are not used. And cryptography cannot work if it's not used. So CryptoCat is trying to fix both problems. So how will it do it? First, CryptoCat works in a browser. It's a browser plugin, but it works in a browser. That takes care of a few problems. The first one being multi-platform. Another one is that everyone that wants to have secure conversations already has most of the software in his computer, because nowadays everyone has a browser. You only need to fetch the plugin, but most of the browser you have it already. Another thing is, I don't know if any of you already tried to convince his loved one and relatives to stop using Facebook chat and start using Pidgin, Jitsi, or anything that can use OTR only for you and always with you, and don't use anything else with you. It doesn't work. You will lose a lot of friends. So at least with the browser plugin, we don't need people to change all their habits, because they will not do it if it's too hard. Another thing is that it's a browser plugin approach. At first, CryptoCat used JavaScript served by the server in a web page. And it turns out it was a terrible idea. Basically, it completely breaks the threat model of CryptoCat, and we cannot expect to have security with that approach. Nadim would say that currently browsers are not ready for JavaScript encryption, but that's another debate. And of course, just because it's proven to be broken and just because it doesn't work doesn't mean a big company software will try to implement it and claim it is secure. Sorry. Next, it's eye candy. That's a very big issue. We need it to be eye candy because people should not fear the powerful tools we give to them. People will not use Pidgin or anything that has complicated fingerprints and such. We need people to understand what they use and to feel confident what they use. Do not overcrowd them with features and buttons. They need to get right to the features, and it has to be beautiful to be used. It runs over regular XMPP, so nothing new there. nothing complicated. It works, so we use it. And it has multi-party encryption protocol. That is what CryptoCat brings to the table. It's loosely based on OTR, but it's not OTR. So do not expect to have possible deniability. We don't have it yet. We may have it in the future, but right now it's not there. But yeah, because OTR is such a great protocol, we try to use its specification as a model and to make it look like OTR because it's a good basis. And of course, when you want in a chat room to have a private conversation with one person, we use regular OTR because it works and there is no need to reinvent the wheel and there is no reason not to. So what does the project need right now? So of course, we need testing by people who know cryptography, JavaScript, anything that the project uses for obvious reasons. And for less obvious reasons, we need testers that have no idea what encryption is, what JavaScript is, what a browser is. The most uneducated they are the best. That's simply because the people we are targeting are those people, not the power users, not me, not probably you, because we already have, we know how to use cryptographic tools. We need other people to use them, and for that we need CryptoCat to fit their needs. And when regular testers like us give feedback, we do not see that things are not obvious. We do not see what other people might miss, what they might need. We are not objective, so we need real people who really don't know about that, we are not used to secure conversations, to use that and to give us feedback, to tell us, I didn't know what a fingerprint was, it wasn't clear enough, I didn't find the fingerprints, it didn't pop up good enough, that is missing, this command, I didn't know it existed. We need to fix that because it's their needs we need to address, not ours, it's their needs. We also need a lot of research on multi-party chat room encryption, because it's something that's relatively new. it's a new field and there isn't nearly enough research on it. There may and there will be non-obvious implications on doing multi-party chat room encryption. It adds a lot of complexity to the what you can expect to how we do encryption, how we do authentication and such. So we really need academic research to be done on that field to know what are the limitations of what we are doing and what you can expect, what you cannot expect, and if it's at all possible to do in a secure manner. We need peer review, of course. That's another debate because to me, peer review in the cryptography community is basically broken. There are a few projects to unbreak it from CryptoDotis. Check it out. But yeah, we need it. We need to bring peer review because it doesn't happen on itself. And currently, CryptoCat and other projects do not have nearly enough peer review, even if they look popular, even if a lot of people use it. Experts and such do not review it as they should, as we want them to do it. So we need people to come in and read the specification, read the code, because there is a lot of things we are missing, we may miss and we will miss. And yeah, we need peer review and it doesn't happen just because of popularity. The peer review here also helps with finding flaws and improvements to make. And to implement those improvements, we need coding hands. So we need people who know JavaScript, who are used to browser plugins, who are used to encryption, because there are a lot of things we already identified but haven't fixed yet because of lack of coding hands. And we need more testing because there will never be enough testing. There will always be a bug that we missed and we need a lot of testers. So public service announcement, rapidly. Please, I cannot stress this enough. Don't let the GUI mislead you. It's beautiful right now because Nadim likes 8-bit stuff. He's very good at making things look good. But it may look like a finished product, but it is not. It's still a very young protocol. It's still in early stages. And it cannot be considered ready for life and the situations. It may look like a very sleek project that's a reworking that already does everything right, but excuse me, believe me, it's not the case. right now we cannot consider it safe for a life and death scenario. So if you, if something goes wrong and all the encryption breaks and nothing gets encrypted, if in that case you are in danger, please don't use CryptoCat. But the good news is it's not that bad actually. It's ready for everyday privacy. So with your friends, with communities, lesbian and gay communities. But just don't use it when your adversary may kill you, may imprison you, or for very serious situations. Just use it. We need people to use it. So please use it. Don't refrain from using it. But if it's a very dangerous situation, please use something else or go back to OTR or things that are very finished and reviewed and proven, because CryptoCat is not yet that product. But nevertheless, it's a very cool project and it has a lot of potential. And maybe with your help, we can achieve that level of security of being proven, and maybe one day it may be a very useful tool for life and the situation. Maybe one day it will be ready for that, and then maybe one day it will change something in the field. But we need people and we need help to achieve that goal, and the more people come, the earlier we are ready for those situations. So please come join us. Here is the website, the specification, the threat model, the IRC channel, the GitHub. Please open issues, be it for bugs, improvements, proposals, everything that's useful. We need your help. And even just opening a debate, opening a conversation, do you think that's good, that's bad, just opening a debate, it's really a great help. Because other people will join in and the conversation will go on, and very useful stuff usually comes out of those debates. Yes, please come join us. If you want to chat with me, I will be outside, either in the corridor or in the cold. And please come troll me, be it for criticism, be it constructive or not, trolling, suggestions, comments, I'm there.
And if you have questions, we have 3 minutes for a small QA session.
Really? Ouch.
Would someone have a question? Okay. You have the micro?
You're running fast. Small questions. I really like CryptoCat, even if I'm coming from the crypto part and so on, but are you working on specifically on the cover channel part, because I think...
Excuse me, on what?
The cover channel. The cover channel. So are you... Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So are you working on this?
Okay. The thing is, right now we have to do those choices. We need to discuss whether we want, for example, a public list of channels and a password to enter channels or not.
I'm talking about hiding the protocol inside another protocol. So for example, the thing is, a lot of those protocols are detected by, if you, for example, use this protocol in Iran or in Israel, whatever, you get intercepted and you get detected because the protocol has
okay,
a specific pattern.
You can, for example, use CryptoCat over Tor. That would be useful.
You know, Tor is blocked in some countries.
Yeah, so but there is the OBFS proxy system that obfuscates the Tor protocol. So there is a lot of work in Tor to make it pass through every sensor chip, every filtering. So my advice would be to use CryptoCat over Tor. And use anything you want to be covered by a protocol, use Tor.
So you will use a different protocol for doing the covering of your protocol.
Yeah, CryptoCat, it's not in CryptoCat threat model to take care of that problem. It should be Tor does it well, and I don't think CryptoCat would be should really obfuscate itself right now.
Okay, thank you.
Keep it simple.
Another question?
Just as an example of a covert channel that might be in interesting to, mm-hmm. to attack. You're trying to, obviously you're trying to hide what people are talking about. But if you look at the traffic and see that they always talk, they're always on active on days following certain events, then you can make a guess about what they're talking about. So then you might want to be able to cover things like
that. Yeah, of course. And by background traffic. For that, you can use Tor every day, and yeah. each day you browse random pages or use Tor for everything.
But then
every
do day. do you need this at all if you use Tor?
That's an interesting question, but. Yeah, you could implement chatroom encryption with Tor hidden services. Some people have tried that, but yeah, it's another approach. It may work, it may not. The cool thing about CryptoCat is it relies on XMPP, so you don't need to set up a Tor Tor hidden service and such to make it work. It just like for a moment keep it simple, stupid, and. If there is a real need to completely change the CryptoCat protocol, why not? But right now, until there is a reason to make it more complicated, we keep it simple. There was a question right there, I think. Sir? He raised his hand twice, but I think he had a question. No? Is he ignoring me? Hello? You had a question? You?
Yeah.
Do you have a question or not? You're killing me.
Will you allow features like using passwords to join a chat room?
Yeah, that's what I thought was the first question. That's a good question. We are thinking about it, but the thing is. We don't know yet if we should use the name of the conversation as the password, like some Pastebin does. If there should be a password in there to enter the chat, how do we set it up? Who manages this password? So there are several ways to achieve that, and we're not focused on one right now. I have an idea, but we have to discuss it before we implement stuff. We need to discuss it because people should give feedback and maybe. Our ideas are very stupid, and people should tell us it's stupid. So right now, we haven't decided of our way to do it yet, but well, it's something we need to do.
The thing is, the name of the chat room is one thing, but you can basically just look at every name and until you find
exactly.
Something.
Right now, you cannot list the exact. You cannot make a list of all the chat rooms, so that's that. But yeah, we need to improve that, and we need to find a system. And if you have inputs or idea, please come open an issue ticket. I think there is one open for that. If not, open it and open the debate. We need it.